Way back in February, we tore down Apple's Vision Pro, a true marvel of spatial computing. The Vision Pro was loaded with high-quality cameras that produced some of the best video pass-through we've seen, and tracking sensors sensitive enough to track the movement of your fingers. But all of that came at a price, $4,000 to start, and that proved to be a barrier for most people. So that got us thinking, is there a cheaper way for people to experience the magic of spatial computing, and if so, what is it? Just like anyone looking for deals, we headed straight to AliExpress and quickly found what looks like a bargain on a Vision Pro-like headset. And according to the listed specs, this headset will have a whopping 256 gigabytes of RAM? You've seen the best, now it's time to see the rest. Presenting the Vision SE, making its grand debut on iFixit's Teardown table. It's something to behold, alright. While this Vision SE does have some movement tracking, the only way to navigate the menus is by turning your head to look at whatever it is you want to interact with. To select something, you have a conveniently placed button along the side of the headset. There are no pinch gestures here, but we do have a controller that's a lot like the old Soviet Tournier console controllers, and it also needs to be tethered to the headset. We asked our friends over at Creative Electron to x-ray this, but honestly, I'm not sure why. Comparing it to the Vision Pro, which, by the way, the manufacturer of this thing is doing, not us, is like looking at the launch version of Cyberpunk 2077 on the PS5. Time to take a look inside. The head straps and face cushion detach easily enough, and the screw placements around the Fresnel lenses are reminiscent of the Quest 2. Pretty standard so far. And good news, if the built-in storage isn't enough, you have the option of inserting a microSD right here where it can dig into your forehead. After removing the screws securing the front plate, I get to work on prying it up and off. Whoops, there goes that piece. Popping the cheap plastic away is a bit of a struggle, but once it's away, it allows me to disconnect the proximity sensor. I've got a few more screws that'll need to come out before we can remove the heart of the device, but it's worth noting here that unlike Apple's Vision Pro that had automatic eye tracking and IPD adjustment, in this headset there's no IPD adjustment of any kind. But don't worry, the eye strain you'll experience is nothing compared to the discomfort of actually having to use this device for anything at all. Let's move on to that front plastic plate. It doesn't take long to overpower the clips and send it flying across the table. Like peeling an onion, inside the Vision SE is what looks a lot like a Timu version of a Quest 2. A fan without a heatsink, a battery that looks like it was shoved in as an afterthought, and the barest of bare external sensors. I will say this though, at least the battery can be easily disconnected and accessed right off the bat. That's good, though I doubt it was done specifically with repairability in mind. With the fan and camera assembly out, I'm gonna go ahead and remove the battery, which comes in at 11.4 watt hours, smaller than even the Quest 2's 14 watt hour battery. The mainboard is out next, and it's pretty basic. There's a couple of Qualcomm ICs on there, and the whole thing is powered by a Samsung embedded multi-chip package. After a few screws here and there, the plastic centerpiece releases, and the lens and screw assembly are away. The core component of any VR or XR headset is the screen, and in most instances, it's the single most expensive component. In this case though, the display is none other than the panel we found in the Quest 2, which as far as expense goes, will only cost you about $70. Surprise! So the question is, should you ever buy a device like this? And the answer is unequivocally no. This is nothing more than an e-waste. It's a gimmick at best. Do yourself a favor, go on eBay and buy a used Quest 2. Not only will you be extending the life of a device that's already out there, but you're gonna have a better VR experience too.